So top of mind for me and for our company at IBC this year is really looking at how the transition from conventional broadcast to digital is really accelerating. What's really interesting to us and to me in particular is that consumer expectations have already made the transition where consumers are expecting their premium content to be on any device, anytime, anywhere, and available. On demand, whether it's ad-supported or subscription or transactional, whatever the business model may be, the expectation is there. And what's amazing is the consumer shift in that behavior and expectation has happened so fast, and now consumers are pulling the industry forward, right? And a lot of existing broadcasters are still entrenched in 7-year buying cycles for updating their platforms and making changes and investment. But they're all realizing that digital has no longer a side initiative and has actually become core and central to the future of their industry. We, of course, at Brightcove are kind of digital natives in that sense. We come from a combination of media and software, but everything we do is based in the cloud. And so for us, it's about saying, okay, is the industry now catching up to a point where we can really accelerate or help them accelerate their transition? Maybe start with kind of who our customers are in the media side of our business, which we have a very, very strong focus on, and it's a significant growth area. It's fundamentally where all the streams are, right? And media for us is really defined broadly as those businesses for whom content is the key product, right? So video is their product. It's not necessarily the marketing tool that they use to drive the top end of the marketing funnel, but rather it is the content that they look to monetize. It's their product. It's the heart of their business. And that means broadcast programmers, content aggregators, pure play digital over-the-top services, new media companies in areas like esports, which is growing, traditional print publishers, et cetera. So that range of customers has a whole set of unique use cases, right? The macro level trends that affect media and the industry in general are the consumer shift in expectations, the proliferation of devices, the penetration of broadband delivery across the world, et cetera, et cetera. The rise, I think one really interesting thing is the democratization of content, right? So mostly media companies we're talking about premium content. And then there's on the other end of the spectrum, the user generator or long tail content. And we see an interesting thing happening where there's a kind of a blending happening on those two ends of the spectrum. And major media companies are realizing that, hey, there's this democratization happening where content that is not necessarily professionally produced is actually highly valuable, right? So all of these things are happening. And with them, there's a host of challenges that arise. And fundamentally, the way to kind of encapsulate them all is that there is an increasing amount of complexity, right? So if you have premium content and you want to deliver that content to all these devices, well, there's different platforms, there's social distribution, does my content need to have digital rights management? Do I have to have captions? What about multiple languages? Do I have the right formats? How many different formats do I need to have? How many renditions should I have? How do I actually mix maybe a live stream from a live event or take a simulcast of an existing broadcast stream or pop up a new virtual channel? There's a range of these things. And that matrix of, platforms and devices and, all these other capabilities creates a dizzying array of variables, if you will. And navigating that is challenging, right? So part of what we do with our media customers is say, look, we have a global footprint with offices throughout North America, London, and the rest of Europe, Dubai, Singapore, Korea, Tokyo, Sydney. And so within that footprint, we're dealing with leading media companies globally. And on that basis, we can actually see what their experiences are, bring those together, and help our other customers navigate, their future roadmap of what they need to do, what the best ways are for them in particular to perhaps apply best practices, make the right technology decisions, and help them prepare for the future. Our EMEA office, right, Europe, Middle East, Africa, is headquartered in London. We have folks kind of scattered throughout the region. And obviously, there are differences between kind of the North American market and the European market. one, you know, some of the things that are very obvious, right, are there are yet to be widely adopted standards. Just in terms of, you know, delivery protocol, if you think about the fact that, you know, the world is moving towards HLS, but then there's the advent of Dash, and there are existing large media companies that have already prepared and encoded their content, you know, in a variety of ways. How do you help them make the migration to the future? DRM is a big deal across Europe because, you know, they need to protect the premium content. That's true, you know, globally, but more fundamentally important outside of the U.S. It seems. Multiple languages is another key, but what I think the most important factor, right, is aligning technology choices and decisions with a successful business model. And many of these companies we're talking about have, you know, millions of dollars, if not billions, invested in kind of the conventional business and are looking to make that transition, but want to do so in a very profitable fashion, right? So what we keep top of mind is as we, you know, help them usher in the adoption of cloud technology to deliver and monetize content across all these screens for their audiences, how to do so in a way that is profitable and, you know, cognizant of the economic realities they face. And that's going to vary from country to country, company to company. Thank you.